Welcome to today's session of YouTube classes. So far in the previous classes, you people have learned about the structure of the C++ program, how to write a program in C++, and also how to create a data type, what is a data type, how to declare the elements, that is your variables or constant in your program. Today, we are going to learn about chapter 9, that is input and output operations. With the help of the different operators available in C++, you people have learned how to process the given data there, like arithmetic computation, relational comparison, or logical computation, etc. Whatever operations you want to do there, you people have learned there. But today, we are learning about how to give an input to the program with the help of what function, what header files to be needed, and also how to create or how to display the result back onto the output screen of your program after running the program. So today in chapter 9, we are going to learn in detail the input and output operators. Hope you remember now what is an input. That is, reading data into the program, we call it as input. And what is output, displaying result back onto the monitor, we call it as output. So, input and output operations in your C++ are normally done using two library functions, that is cin and cout. They also call it as function, or you can also call it as objects of the class iostream. So, in order to use this, I need to include a header file, that is iostream.h. This will help me to interact with the user, either to display the result onto the monitor or on getting the user's input from the keyboard, whatever value the user enters. So, whenever a data is transferred in bits and bytes from one component to another, this sequence of bytes or characters from one source to destination, we call or we use the technical term that we call it as stream. So, what is a stream? Stream is a sequence of bytes or characters from source to destination. It may be either from keyboard to your program or from program onto your monitor. That's why there are two types of stream. First one is input stream. So the name itself says input means I'm reading data from the keyboard and passing it on to the program. That's why input stream means it is the stream which reads data from an input device, standard input device, all of you know, that is your keyboard to program. On the other hand, when I say output stream, it is the stream which writes or displays the data from the program onto your standard output device, that is your monitor. So, to receive the data from input device and send the result back to your output device, in order to use your cin and cout functions, you need to include a standard library file, that is iostream.h, in your preprocessor block. It defines the class library of iostream. Iostreams are nothing but input and output streams. Let us learn one by one what is cin function or input operation and cout function, that is output operation. In order to perform input operation, that is reading the values to the variables of the program, I need an operator which we call it as input operator, and it is represented with the symbol 2 greater than symbols there, and it is always used along with cin object because cin function or object is used to read the values from the keyboard into the program element. So, the operator, that is 2 greater than symbols or input operator, it is also known as extraction operator or get from operator, which reads the value. It reads the value from the standard input device. You need to remember the keyword, that is reads. It reads the value whatever user gives from the keyboard and it places into the variable whichever you are calling in that Cin function. So the input operator or what is an extraction operator will be the question in your paper. You need to say it is an operator or a get from operator which reads the values from a standard input device, that is keyboard, and it is always used along with Cin object. So what is a Cin function? When I am using an operator with Cin function, I should know what is Cin function. So Cin stands for console input. It is the function used to read the values. The definition for input operator and Cin function remains the same. Both of them are used to read values from the standard input device, that is keyboard, with the help of input operator, that is your 2 greater than symbol. Either in 1 mark they will ask you what is input operator or extraction operator, or name the operator which is used along with Cin function. That also they may pose. So for both you need to remember the keyword. It reads the values from standard input device. Normally when they ask to name the operator used along with Cin function, student get confused and they will write it as insertion operator. It is wrong. You should remember the opposite of it. That is Cin is extraction operator. The syntax for Cin function is Cin, extraction operator and the variable name. So whatever variable name you specify, whatever user enters the value from the keyboard, it is placed into that particular variable. And all Cin statements must terminate with semicolon. You people know about it because it is an executable statement. For example, here I have an example where I am declaring int n. Hope you remember, int specifies the integer value. That is, n is a variable that stores an integer value or a number without decimal value. After that, I am going to say Cin operator and n semicolon. That means whatever user enters until he presses enter key. I will give a long number of 3, 5, 4, 6 and press enter key. Once the user presses an enter key, then the value gets stored at the memory where I have named it as n. So this statement, first one declares an integer variable n and the second statement reads a value for n from the keyboard until enter key is pressed. You should remember that all the variable, if I am inputting more than one variable, each variable in Cin statement must be preceded with extraction operator, or we also call it as input operator. Now let us see how to perform output operation. It is done with the help of output operator and the symbol used is 2 less than symbol. For input, we use 2 greater than symbols, and in Cout, we use 2 less than symbols, which we call it as output operator. It is normally used to display the result or value onto your monitor, that is your standard output device. It is also known as insertion operator. You people must know, in Cin, I use extraction operator. But in Cout to output, I use insertion operator. This is what I specified. Normally when they say Cin, you people will write insertion operator, and for output you write extraction operator. But it is the reverse of it. In Cin, you should write extraction operator, and in Cout you should write insertion operator. This is because I am going to insert the result from my program onto the monitor, that is your display device. So Cout is a function used to display the text or values. I can display either text or values to standard output device, that is monitor. So the operator used along with Cout function In order to display the value onto the monitor, we call it as output operator, and the other name for it is insertion operator, right? The syntax for cout statement, in cin you had cin operator and variable name, but when I am displaying text onto the screen, when I want to display the sum of two numbers is, I am not displaying only the value, I need to display the text also, that is, this is the area of triangle or sum of two numbers, like that I have to display the text also. So in cout statement I will have two elements, that is, one is your expression or the text, whatever string, whatever you are going to display, and that is always represented in double quotes, and then I'll call the variable which is storing my result in the program. So the syntax will be cout operator, that is insertion operator, and an expression or manipulator, whatever I use there, close quote. After that, the variable name also must be preceded with your insertion operator or output operator, and then I'll call the variable and I will terminate it with semicolon. For example, if I want to display the sum of two numbers is and display that sum, for example, if I am adding A and B, that is 10 and 15 respectively, the sum will be 25. So when I say cout, the sum of two numbers is, I'll call the sum, it will display the output as the sum of two numbers is and 25. One more thing you should be alert, whenever we want to use constant strings, strings are nothing but sequence of characters, we must enclose them in double quotes. And after you close double quote only, the insertion operator should come. Many of you will write the operator, will not close it. So whatever text you are displaying, after displaying it, close the quote, then write the operator, and then write your variable, whatever you are calling with. Whenever I use an insertion operator, before that or after that, the quote should begin, and before that the quote should end. That you should be alert. Let us see an example for your cout function. If at all I want to print the text, sum as it is, as a text, I put them in double quotes. That is in your example 1. Cout, which operator? Insertion operator, double quote and sum, semicolon. Cout is also an executable statement. Just like you are seeing, all cout statement must terminate with semicolon. You should be alert with that. So cout operator, if I want the text to be printed as it is, whatever you display in double quotes, whatever you put, either the text, a symbol, an operator, whatever you put, that will be displayed as it is onto your screen, that is your monitor. So for some, if I use double quotes, it is considered as a string or a text, so it will print sum as it is. But on the other hand, in the second line, I am just calling sum. When I don't use the double quotes, I am naming it as a variable which has stored the result of sum of two numbers there. So cout, I just call the sum, prints the content of the variable, that is your sum. So this is for output of single line. If at all I want to output multiple lines in my result, for example, the sum of two numbers is, the difference of two numbers, or total marks scored, average marks scored, percentage scored, then I want to output them in multiple lines. So in order to perform line break, then I want the second line to come to the next line. Normal typing, you will use the enter key. But in output, how to get the text to the next line, or how to perform a line break? We can use a escape sequence, that is, hope you remember escape sequence. All escape sequence are used to format the outputs, right? So I'll use backslash with a single letter there. So backslash and n represents a new line character, that means the text following it will be displayed in the next line. Or I can also use a manipulator which is available in iomanip.h. In the header files, I have a ready or inbuilt manipulator, that is ANDL. end L. For end L, I don't use the code, but escape sequence, I need to represent it in double quotes. I have explained it with an example. For example, I want to print the value of the pi is, and the value I want to print it in the next line, that is 3.14. You can write it as cout the value of the pi is, close quote, semicolon. Then in next cout statement, I am representing slash n, and in next cout, I am printing the value 3.14. So the output will come as the value of the pi is, and in the next line, you will get it as 3.14. Or using endl function, I can write it as cout the value of the pi is, that is the text I want to display. So that entire text must be represented in double quotes. I terminate, and in the next cout statement I say endl, the cursor will come to the next line, and then I will print the value, that is 3.14. So slash n or end line or endl manipulators are used to perform line break. So now we know how to input a data into the program with cin function and how to output the result back onto the monitor with the help of my cout statement or cout function. Now, if at all I want to input multiple values, for example, in a program, if I say sum of two, three numbers, then I need to input three numbers, not one number. Then in that case, whenever I want to input multiple values or I want to display multiple results in one statement, then I call it as cascading of I/O operations. So this is done with the help of using the insertion operator that is used along with cout function and an extraction operator that is used along with cin function multiple times. So the process of inputting multiple values or outputting multiple results with the help of input and output operators using them multiple times, we call it as cascading of I/O operations. The definition will be asked for 1 mark also. So inputting or using insertion and extraction operators multiple times in order to output or input multiple values in a single statement, we call it as cascading. If a program requires more than one input variable, then it is possible to input these variables in a single cin statement using extraction operator multiple times. For example, to read A, B, C, I have taken the same example. Cin, operator A, operator B, and operator C. So all the variables, each variable should precede with an operator. I cannot write it like a declaration, Cin, A, B, C. That mistake many students do there. But each variable should precede with extraction operator. Similarly, when we want to output more than one results, then it is done with single cout statement by using multiple insertion operator. So cout A, B, C, each variable must precede with your insertion operator. Let us see an example for cascading of I/O operators. Example, if I want to enter two numbers, normally without cascading, I write it as enter the first number, then cin A, enter the second number will be my second message, and I'll say cin B. Instead of using two cin and two cout statements, we can read it in single cin statement to input two numbers by using extraction operator or input operator multiple times. So I'll combine that example and make it as cout enter two numbers will be my message, operator and end line, and in cin, instead of one variable, operator A and extraction operator B terminated with semicolon. Always I remind you, all cin and cout statements are executable statements and you need to terminate with semicolon. If not, compiler will give you an error, semicolon missing. And if I want to output the sum of two numbers, hope you remember what we checked in the last one. The sum of two numbers is one string, and sum is a variable. I want to combine both of them in single cout statement. So when I display multiple items or multiple elements in one single cout statement using your insertion operator multiple times, I call it as cascading. So when I want to output multiple results in single cout statement by using the insertion operator multiple times, example, cout, the sum of two numbers, that is double quotes one, that is one element, and I want to display the result or the value stored at the sum also. So I will say sum, the sum of two numbers is, I'll call the sum, and I will end with end line. End line manipulator, hope you remember that, it will create a new line. That means your output cursor will come to the next line. Whatever you output next to the cout statement will be displayed in the next line of it. So that cascading of IO operators using operators multiple times in either cin statement or cout statement is called as cascading of IO operators. Now we know how to create or how to write a cin statement and cout statement in order to input or output the values to the program and output the results from the program. Now let us see how to manipulate or format an output. If you create a text or a document in your Word, you don't just print it out just like that. You need to format it properly in a required manner. So even the outputs displayed after you run the program, it must be formatted. So I use manipulators. They are the operators which are used along with insertion operator. Insertion operator is used along with cout statement in order to display the results onto the screen. Yes or no? Same way, the manipulators are always used only with cout statement. Many students make a mistake of writing them in cin also. Cin statement is used to read the values from the keyboard to the program. So I don't need any formatting there. So I don't use any manipulators or formatting functions there. So here the manipulators, that's why are defined as the operators used along with insertion operator or in cout statement in order to format the data displayed in cout statement. The most commonly used manipulators are endl and setwidth function, setw, setw we will call it as. Endl already we have discussed along with backslash n. So it is a manipulator. When used along with the output statement, what does it do? It causes a line feed. That means the next text following it will be displayed in the next line, just like your enter key in your Word. If I press enter, whatever I type next to that will be displayed in the next line. Same way, if I want the text to be displayed in the next line after I print one line, then I use endl function. But you should be careful. In order to use that, I need to include my iomanip.h. In order to use setwidth function, I should check as soon as I use setw in my program, I should go back and check in my preprocessor directive whether I have included iomanip.h. So a tip I want to give you is, in any program, include three standard header files so that you will not forget that while inserting it in your program. That is your iostream.h, iomanip.h and conivo.h. So endl manipulator is used to cause a new line character. Example, I have taken XYZ PU Science College, Bangalore. I want it in the next line. So in first cout statement, after I display this XYZ PU College, I am using endl function. So the output also is displayed next. It will come in two lines, that is XYZ PU Science College in one line and Bangalore in another line. Then your setw manipulator. It was used to set the width of the field assigned for the output, just like your tab key in your keyboard. Whenever I press a tab key, it will give me a fixed amount of space from one character to another. So if I want to print numbers continuously 1 to 10 with a fixed space, then I'll use setw function. So in the setw function, Within your function bracket, I should mention the space I am giving, the 6 bytes or what 6 bytes, whatever space you are giving. So it sets the width of the field assigned to the output. Example, cout set w 6 and I am calling the text or the string r. So r will take 1 byte, the rest of the 5 bytes will be given it as a space before that value. As I said, in order to use these manipulators, you should include iomanip.h. Let us discuss some of the programming examples in order to understand input and output operators. Okay, so I have taken the simple program to find the sum of two numbers. When I say a program to find the sum of two numbers, first we should analyze, whenever you try to write a program, divide that program into three concepts. That is, what input I want, what process I am doing, and what is the output I want to display. So when I say sum of two numbers, what do I want it from the user? I need two numbers. For that, I need two elements. Then what I have to compute in this program? I need to compute my sum. So I need one more element there. Whatever I have computed the sum, that will be my output. So to begin the program with, you people know you need to include your header files in your preprocessor directive. So the common header files are iostream.h and conivo.h. Along with that, you need to use iomanip.h also. Then followed by main function, I say void main, the main need not return any value. Then how many elements I need for this program? Three elements I need this program, and all are integer data type. So I declare three variable after your flower bracket, declaration statement, int, a comma, b comma, sum, and all statements must terminate with semicolon. Then I use clear screen function, CLR, SCR function, to clear your output screen. Then before I say, as soon as I declare, I need to write my input statements. Directly I cannot use cin function there because I should display what the user have to enter. For example, if you go to your ATM machine, it should display enter your card or insert your card. Like that, I should give a message for the user to give me the numbers. So first will be my cout statement. Any input block will have one cout statement where I am giving the message, and then I will use cin to read it into the program memory. So what I want the user to enter, he need to enter two numbers. So in cout, I will say enter two numbers. So that is the text. So I am displaying it in double quotes. Terminate with semicolon. I am reading two numbers. So cascading of input and output, input operator, you should remember. I am reading two numbers. So cin operator A, operator B. In declaration, elements are separated by comma. But in cin, two variables must be separated or preceded with your extraction operator used in cin statement. Then my process, I want to compute the sum. The expression will be sum equals a plus b. A and b are added and assigned back to the sum. Then I'll output that. I just can't display the number. I want to give the text along with that. So in cout, whatever text I want to display, the sum of two numbers is represented in double quotes. And then I'll call the variable, that is sum. And I'll use the manipulator endl there. Then terminate or end your program with getch function on clear screen, and getch are functions, so they should have function bracket next to them. Terminate with semicolon and close the program there. Let us take up one more program to interchange the values of two variables using third variable. This is actually your lab program number one. So what do the program says? Before I start writing the code, I should understand what the problem is. So the problem says that I have two numbers in two variables. I want to exchange them by using a third variable. So what do I need it as an input? I want two variables. I'll name it as A and B. I want to exchange it using third variable. The third variable I will name it as temp. So just understand the program before you write the program code. If I have in a box one biscuit and another box I have got chocolate, how do you exchange them? I cannot just swap them as it is. I need a third bowl or a third box to interchange them. That will be acted as with a variable temp. So what is the input I need here? A and B. Then you should use temp. First I will transfer the box 1 to the temperature, that is temp variable, temp equals A. Then the second box, that is B, will be placed to A. Then the B will become empty. Then whatever I have put it in the temp, I will put it back to the B so that the values gets exchanged there. Right? So let us begin. Include your header files with hash include, start void main and open bracket. How many variables I need here? 3 variables I need. A, B to input and temp to swap. So declare 3 variables, A, B, temp in integer. Clear screen function is default for all the programs. You should write it. Then I want the user to enter 2 numbers. So before I read, I should give the message enter 2 numbers. Whenever I want to display the message, I will use cout function. So cout, insertion operator in double quotes, enter the 2 numbers, terminate with semicolon. Then read 2 numbers, that is cin, A, B. I'll use extraction operator before each variable. I cannot write like a declaration A, B. A, B must proceed with your extraction operator there. So cin, operator A, operator B, terminate with semicolon. Then before interchanging, I want to print the number. So I will cout. Whenever I want to display, I will use cout function. So cout, what you are printing before interchanging A. So A equals, close the quote, I'll call my A. Then I want the text and B equals. So the again operator and the text is placed, call the B and use end line to get it to the next line. Then I will start the process of swapping. First put A to temp. So temp equals A. Always in assigning operator, the left hand operator will receive the value from the right hand operator. So say temp equals A means A is copied to temp. Temp equals A semicolon, then put B to A. So A equals B, then B equals temp var. So this process, this block will assign, or this will complete your process. So after process, I want to display whether it is displayed or interchanged or not. Then in cout, again I will repeat the same statement as you have before interchanging. After interchanging, A equals, close quote, I am calling A value, so I should use operator and A, and B equals, call B and end line, get CH and close the bracket. The example is displayed on one more box there. So A I will assign with 10, assume B equals temp 20. When I say temp equals A, temp get assigned with A value, that is 10. When I say A B equals B, the B value get assigned to the A. So A becomes 20. Now again temp I am placing it to the B. So B equals temp means temp I have got 10. So the B is get assigned with 10. So after that, if I display before A is 10, B is 20. And after A becomes 20 and B becomes 10. Let us take up one more example. This is your practical program number 2 that numbered as 1B. Here the program is same. To interchange the value of 2 variables without using third variable. That means you will not have temp here. I will have only A and B and I should swap it using a different logic. So the program code remains the same. Only the processing part you need to remember in this program. So I'll include my header files. I'll start my main, void main, flower bracket. I don't want temp. I want only 2 numbers. So I'll declare int A, B, semicolon. Clear screen is CLRSER function is mandatory for all the programs. Now I want the user to enter 2 numbers that I display with cout statement. Enter 2 numbers. And I'll read it into A and B, cin, extraction operator A, extraction operator B, semicolon. Before interchanging, I'll display. The statement remains the same. Then when I come to process, look into the example there. If A equals 10 and B equals 20, when I say A equals A plus B, I don't have temp here. So I'll add both of them and assign to A. So A get assigned with 30. Here first you should compute A only, then compute B, then again back compute A. The order you should remember. Then I'll compute B. B equals A minus B. So at this statement, A doesn't have 10. A is overwritten with 30. So 30 minus 20, which is there in the B. So B get assigned with 10. So after this statement, B will not have 20, but B will be storing 10. Again, I'll use the same logic for A. A equals A minus B. So at this, A has got 30 only and B is replaced with 10. So 30 minus 10, that equals 20. So A will become 20. Look at that. In the beginning, A was 10, B was 20. And after processing all the three statements, B became 10 and A became 20. That is, we have interchanged the values of both the variables. This is the logic we use it in this particular program. Let us discuss one more program, that is to find the area and circumference of the circle. The algorithm of this you people have learned in problem solving only. So here I need to compute area and circumference of a given circle. To compute that, what is the input I need? I need radius. So how many elements I need to declare in this program? Radius, area, circumference. So I need three elements to be declared. What is the formula for area you should know? That is pi r square. R square I cannot represent as it is. So it should be expanded as pi into r or pi into radius. And for circumference I need to say 2 pi r. That means 2 into pi into radius. So let us start the program. I include all your header files. Here you have one more statement which I call it as hash define pi 3.14. In your formula, the value of the pi remains as constant. That is, for any given radius, pi remains as 3.1415. So instead of putting it again and reading it from the user, I define it as a global variable. When a variable is declared above void main function or above all the function, I call it as global variable. And I use one more preprocessor command, that is hash define. So that will define a symbolic constant. Here when I am assigning, I don't use assigning operator. I'll give the variable name, space, value what I am assigning. So hash define, variable name is pi. Observe, that is in capital. If you declare variables in capital, I should use them the same in throughout my program. If I declare them in small letters, I should write in the entire program in small letters only. So hash define, because C++ is case sensitive. So hash define pi I have declared in capital. I am assigning the value 3.14, which will be used in your processing. I have marked it with arrow. So how many variables I need? I need three variables, and all of them may have decimal point because they may ask you to compute the area of the circle with the radius 3.5, 4.2, like that, any value they can give in your geometry. So float, RAD is my for radius, area is I am computing area, and circum is to compute my circumference. Instead of keeping the variable name so long, I am reducing it into circum. Then clear screen, as I said, CLR, SCR is mandatory for all the program. Then what I want the user to enter, I want the user to enter radius. So I will see out, enter radius, see in. The variable name is RAD. Then compute area with what I explained, PI into RAD, because radius is stored in the variable RAD. Circumference I compute with circum equals 2 into PI into RAD. Then output your area and circumference with cout statement. First is area of circle equals call area end line. Cout circumference of circle equals call circum and end line, and end it with get ch and closing bracket. So before closing, here are some of the questions for your practice, and also you have some of questions to write the program. Please try it. All the best.